Everybody's got things that money can't buy. If the ones you love are sitting right beside you, then I'd say you got a lot. The best things in life are straight from his hands. It's like raising kids on a piece of land. A little peace of mind when the day is done. Where you think that comes from, that's gifts from God.
Good evening, everyone, and a very happy Sabbath to all of you. It's so nice to worship the Lord together, and amidst all the bad things happening around, God has protected us, kept us safe and sound throughout the week, safely through another week, He has carried us. It's so sad to see so many sad things happening around, and we hear of sad things every day, but we just need to trust in God and ask Him for His leading. Before we begin any further, we'll bow our heads for prayer. Heavenly Father in heaven, we thank Thee for giving us another opportunity to come together as a family, to worship You and to adore You, Father. As we come before Your presence, open our hearts and minds, cleanse us from all our unrighteousness, Father. We ask that Your presence be amidst us, and may You lead us throughout this worship as we open Your word and learn from Thee, Father. We commit all of us into Your care. We ask You that You would be amidst us throughout this time of prayer as we worship You and we praise You, Father. We ask a few blessings in Your holy name. Amen. I'm reading from Psalms 91. I feel the psalm is a very apt psalm at this point of time. As we see the pandemic, we see so many deaths around. I am very thankful for keeping you safe and sound. Just yesterday, my doctor who was working with me, she was fine. And then today, I hear that she's COVID positive. And it's only God's blessings that God has kept me safe amidst all the sickness. He's been carrying me through, and we just need to trust in Him. I'll read through Psalms 1 as we wait for everyone to join in, and followed by the song service. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver the snare of the fowler and from the perilous pestilence. And under His wings shall you take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and your buckler. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Only your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High your dwelling place. No evil shall befall you, no plague shall come near your dwelling, for He shall give His angels to charge over you, to keep you in on your ways. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot, because He has set His love upon me. Therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. What a wonderful promise we have from Psalm chapter 91. Every day before I go for work, I read the Psalm and I go. It gives me so much of courage, and I hope it does the same with you as well. We'll move ahead with the song service.
Happy Sabbath to all of you. We would like to start with the song service. Our first song will be hide me now under your wing.
Hide me.
Yeah. हम लोग और एक गाना गाएंगे, मिसिंग वन मोर सॉन्ग, तुम सा कोई नहीं, तुम सा कोई नहीं।
तुम सा कोई नहीं, तुम सा I'm
you so much for participating in singing. Thank you.
I would like to thank the Godzilla group for taking up the lively song service. Thank you for the wonderful song service and the songs that you sang. I would once again like to welcome each and every one of you who have joined in for this time of prayer. And before we begin any further, I would like to ask Pastor N.G. Kisku to offer the opening prayer. Pastor N.G. Kisku, was he able to join in?
Yeah, they have joined in.
Okay. I'd like to ask Pastor N.G. Kisku to offer the opening prayer.
I was thinking Mary Basti. Yeah, they are joining.
Okay. Michael Mamu, can you offer the opening prayer?
Can you say again? I think he has properly joined now.
Okay. Michael Mamu, can you offer the opening prayer? Pastor M.G. Kisku.
Let's pray. Good. Father in heaven, thank you for the blessings of giving us Sabbath. Thank you for taking care of us throughout the week. Now Sabbath has come and we commit us into thy hand as we begin with a message, with a meeting together with our fellow believers from Godzilla. We pray the Lord bless us that we may always know you love us, you care for us, and you are with us. And as we begin this evening, the meeting, we pray the Lord bless us that we may know that you have been with us throughout the week, and that you are blessing us throughout our life, giving us Sabbath so that we can come in your presence with our fellow believers. We pray the Lord bless each one of us that we may learn to love you more, come in your presence, and be in your care and keeping. We pray the Lord bless the Godzilla group, the Lord bless the Dumka group, the Lord bless all the groups that are meeting here this evening. May your presence and your guidance be always with us. Forgive all our sins and shortcomings. Bless us that we may learn to love you more in our daily life. The time has come that there are so many sicknesses around us. We pray the Lord bless us that we may commit ourselves into thy hand and receive your will and your guidance and your presence in our life. Bless each one of us that we may love you more in our daily experiences. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now at this time, I would like to welcome Jeffrey to come and conduct the Bible quiz. Jeffrey, the time is now.
Good evening and happy Sabbath, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Happy Sabbath.
Just a few minutes, we'll start the quiz in just a few minutes. I hope you all can see the screen. So you all can enter the game game pin, that is 1000116. And today's Bible quiz is from the chapter from the book of Numbers, chapter 19, 20, and 21. I hope you all have read these chapters. We see Delano joining. So far we have only 13 participants. If there are anyone else, please join in fast. We'll start the quiz. Okay, so we'll start the quiz.
Please wait for one more minute.
Okay.
We are ready to start.
Okay, so we'll start the quiz. We have 17 participants. Okay, so the first question is, for an unclean person, they shall take some of the ashes of the heifer and running water shall be put on them in a... You have 10 seconds to answer the question.
Option.
Three of them got right, and the answer to this question is found in Numbers 19, verse 17. We'll move on to the next question. Okay, so far Indore is leading by Jamie and then Delano. Okay, the next question is, the clean person shall sprinkle the unclean on the dash day on the dash day. Only two of them got right. And then the answer to this question is found in Numbers 19, verse 19. Okay, we have Jamie leading, followed by Delano and Indore. The next question is a true or false. You shall give it to Aaron the priest that he may take it outside the camp and it shall be slaughtered before him.
Ten of them got right, and the answer is, to this question is found in Numbers 19, verse 3.
Okay, we have Jamie still leading, followed by Indore and Delano. Next question is, then a man who is clean shall gather up the ashes of the heifer and store them outside the camp in a dash place. Six of you got the right answer.
And the answer to this question is found in Numbers 19, verse 9.
Okay, we have Jamie still leading, followed by Indore and Delano. Next question. And every closed vessel which has cover fastened on it is...
Six of them got right, And the answer to this question is found in Numbers 19, verse 15.
Still, we have Jamie leading, followed by Indor, Delano, MJ, and Kenny. Question number 6. Now, when all the congregation saw that Aaron was dead, all the house of Israel mourned for Aaron for how many days? 13, 37, or 3.
13 of them got right, and the answer to this question is found in Numbers 20, verse 29.
Okay, we have Indor, then Jamie, Delano, MJ, and Kenny. Question number 7. And the Lord spoke to Moses and Aaron in Mount Hor by the border of the
Four of them got right, and the answer is found in Numbers 20, verse 23.
Here we have Jamie again on top, followed by Delano, Indor, MJ, and Stels. Question number 8. Where was Moses when he sent messengers to the king of Edom?
Ten of them got right, and the answer is found in Numbers 20, verse 14.
Okay, we have Delano leading, followed by Jamie, MJ, Indor, and Stels. Question number 9. Then the children of Israel, the whole congregation, came to the wilderness of Zin in the
Only one got right, and the answer is found in Numbers 20, verse 1.
Okay, now we have MJ leading, who has the highest answer streak of 7, followed by Delano, Jamie, Indor, and Stels. Question number 10, it's a true or false. Take the rod, you and your brother Aaron gather the congregation together and hit the rock before their eyes. Is it true or false?
Ten of them got right, and the answer is found in Numbers 22, verse 8.
The answer is false. Okay, we still have MJ leading, Delano, Jamie, Stels, and we have Kenny. Question number 11. Thus Israel dwelt in the land of the Amorites. Then Moses sent to spy out Dash, and they took its villages.
Only two of them got right answer, and the answer is found in Numbers 21, verse 31 and 32.
Okay, still MJ leading, followed by Delano, Jamie, Indore, and Stels. Question number 12. And they journeyed from Oboth and camped at Dash in the wilderness, which is east of Moab.
Only two of them got right, and the answer to this question is found in number 21, verse 11.
We have MJ still leading, Delano, Jamie, Stels, and Indore. Question number 13. The Dash, the Canaanite who dwelt in the south, heard that Israel was coming on the road to Athraim.
Eight of them got the right answer, and the answer is found in Numbers 21, verse 1.
Okay, we still have MJ leading, followed by Delano, Jamie, Indore, and Kenny. Question number 14. Why did the Lord send fiery serpents among the people, and they bit the people, and many of the people of Israel died? Why did Lord send fiery serpents among the people?
Nine of them got right, and the answer is found in Numbers 21, verse 6.
So we have now Jamie leading, followed by MJ, Delano, Indore, and Kenny. Okay, this is the last question. They went up by the way to Bashan. So Og, king of Bashan, went out against them, he and all his people, to battle at.
Six of them got right answer, and the answer is found in Numbers 21, verse 33.
Okay, so we have Kenny at the third place, then Jamie second place, and if I'm not wrong, it's MJ. Yeah, MJ is in the first place. And the runner, we have the runners up, Delano and Stels.
I would like to thank Jeffrey for that wonderful day. I'd like to congratulate all the winners and others who participated. Continue to read the Bibles and then learn more so that we could be blessed. Now we would be blessed by a special song by Dr. Joanne and Dr. Jameson Wilson. They would be rendering to us a special song.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's nice to see all of you once again. So happy that we're able to sing a song together once again. The song is called You Are There For Me. It's one of our favorite songs from the Pilgrims. And we thought we would sing it here for you today. Hope you will be blessed. So I could wear a crown.
Happy Sabbath to everybody. I am Quinston, new to this family, and I'm happy to be part of this family here. Thank you for inviting me to be a part of your service today. And I'm happy that I'm sharing something. I hope I can bring something good to the to everybody who's worshiping together with us today, and hope I'll be able to enlighten. Hopefully God will teach something through me, and I pray that it, we all are richly blessed by what I have to share. With all the turmoil that is going around, I would like to speak on something a little bit different than what people have been usually stressing on, to take our mind off things and to understand some of the basic fundamentals of being a Christian. I have chosen the topic of confession, which is very important right now. The time that we are in, confession is something that we all need to understand well, and we lack in it many times when we look at going through and people to find out about what confession actually is. So let's start with it. I'll read Proverbs 28:13. He that covereth his sins shall not prosper, but whosoever confesseth and forsaketh them shall have mercy. So this verse tells us that we keep the tendency of humans is to just cover up our sins, to find it that we actually did something. But to identify our sins and to confess it before God is something that we as humans need to go past and to understand, and that's how we find mercy in front of God. Confession is something that we don't understand. The definition is like it's a process of submitting our sins before God. That's what confession is defined as. Confession is it's a process of submitting ourselves before God to tell that, hey God, this is that I have done, or before a fellow human being as well. So to understand that we have committed a sin and to submitting that, like saying, God, I have sinned, do something about it. That is called confession. Okay, there are a few types of confessions that we see that we need to understand. First thing is between you and God, and the other one is between you and your neighbor. That is also important. That confession we actually go past in many, many ways. We actually forget about how we need to confess to our neighbor as well, because our neighbor is made in the image of God, and we'll be sinning against God if we do not confess to our neighbor. If we have offended our neighbor and we have to acknowledge that we are wrong, and it is also the neighbor's duty to forgive you if you acknowledge and confess to him. So it goes both ways. It is, as a Christian, it is our responsibility to confess to our neighbor when we wronged our neighbor, as well as our neighbor's responsibility, either our family member, our sister, our brother, our husband, wife, our children, they have to forgive us back. That is what is important as well. Even though we do not do the sin, if our neighbor trespasses against us, we should forgive them. That is important that we need to understand. That's part of confession. You should seek the forgiveness of God too after this, because we have wronged our neighbor who is a child of God. So after asking forgiveness from our neighbor, we have to ask for forgiveness from God. James 5:16 says, confess your faults one to one another and pray for one another. We even need to pray for one another. That's also an important part. We can look at the example of the prodigal son. He came back to his father and said, Lord, I'm reading from the Bible again here. Lord, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and I'm no more worthy to be called thy son. This is a son confessing to his father. I do not remember confessing like this to my father at any point, even though I have done many things wrong against the family, against God, against my father as well. But something that I have learned over time, and we need to confess, saying, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight, and I'm no longer worthy to be called thy son. Okay, what other things of confession that we need to understand? Humility. What is humility? Humility is a primary component of confession that needs to be there for us to actually confess. People who are not humble themselves before God cannot acknowledge their guilt. And they have not fulfilled the first condition of acceptance that will lead to confession. So the only reason that we do not have remission of sins, that we are not willing to humble our hearts and comply to the conditions of the word of the truth. We have many examples. One example that we can see is a tax collector and the publican, the two comparisons that is drawn in the gospel. The tax collector actually, he kept saying like, hey, I am not like these fellows who are bad, who do these sins. I give my tithe every month. I pay my dues. This is what, when you don't have humility, we don't understand what we need to confess. When a publican came and beat his chest in the presence of God and in humility asked for forgiveness, that makes us understand the importance of humility and how humility plays an important role. Even after knowing the deeds that we did, it's important to have humility. The tax collector actually beat his chest and the publican did not. So yeah, one more point of confession. Confession needs to be very specific. Sometimes we confess broadly, like how we have it in the Lord's Prayer, please forgive us as we forgive those who trespass against us. Though that one sentence is actually not enough, because we are not being specific to God, saying, God, I did this sin. Please help me to get past this. Help me to gain forgiveness for this and help me not to repeat this again. Correctly specifying our sins instead of putting them in a huge bracket is important in not sinning again as well. So that confession, that part of confession is very important. If you do not accept it in front of God, it is not a sincere repentance and it will not lead to reformation that God seeks. Look at the confession of David after he sinned, after killing Bathsheba's husband in the battle, putting him in the front of the battle and getting him killed. He put on sackcloth. He confessed for that sin specifically. He has done an extensive prayer that has been recorded in Psalms. He knew what he had done. He acknowledged it. So being specific about what sins we have done is also very important in confession, not broadly terming it in broad terms like how we do it in the Lord's Prayer. Sometimes we think that we have done many sins. Many of us think that we have gone so much astray that we cannot be brought back. My sin is too big to be forgiven. Do we not confess because our sins weigh us down? Do we think that we have drifted too far away? I'll read from Ezekiel 33:15. If the wicked restore the pledge meaning to confess to God, give again that he had robbed. So that is a result of confession. You give back what you have robbed. So result of confession and repentance. Okay, walk in the statutes of life, that is living the correct life. Without committing iniquity, don't go back to our sins. So we don't have to go back to our sins. He shall surely live and shall not die. So if we restore, so the importance is restore the pledge that we have to God and give back what we have robbed and follow and walk in the statutes of life without committing iniquity again, and we shall surely live and not die. Whatever we have done, we have to restore it. There is no sin that is big enough and no sinner that is too far away from God's grace. Let's look, the good example that we have is a confession of thieves next to Jesus, the either side of Jesus when they were crucified, the two thieves. The one thief who was crucified for his sins, actually he confessed and he is saved. The woman at the well, she didn't think that she would be worthy to be saved. She was hiding behind her sins. She was using her sins all around her, that she put a walled it around herself, that she never thought she would be saved. That's why she kept lying to Jesus, and God came and rescued her. Okay, do we not recognize our sins? Do we not understand that we have to confess? Do not realize and accept our sins? When sin has deadened our moral perceptions, the sinner does not realize the faults of his character and does not realize the huge enormity of the evil that he has committed, unless he yields to the convincing power of the Holy Spirit. He remains in partial blindness of his sin. Many times we do that as well. I have been blinded to the sins I have committed many a times because I don't understand. I don't think that, hey, this is actually something that I have done wrong. And I'm blinded towards it, and my moral perceptions have been blurred. Isaac, when he betrayed his brother after listening to his mother, he was blinded by his mother's convincing and also his want for the birthright. So he was blinded by all of that, and he committed a sin that, and he did not realize what he had done as well till many, many years ahead. And he paid for it in many ways. But we should strive not to be like Isaac, to not be blinded by the sin that we're going to commit or we have committed, and not understand that even our close friends may, our close mates may lead us towards sin. One more important point of confession. Are we not willing to confess our sin sometimes? We know that we have done some sin. We know that we have trespassed against God. We justify ourselves and we are not willing to confess our sins. Do we add an apology in excuse? Do we say that if we had not been in certain circumstances, we wouldn't have done that sin? So we are wrongly accused of that sin because God put me in that circumstance, or I had this friend who did this to me, that's why I had to do this sin, or this is what happened, and then that's why I'm not confessing. Remember Adam and Eve. They justified themselves just like this. Oh, the snake, the serpent did this, said this to me, and my wife said this to me, and they gave excuses for their own sins. They found circumstances to fit their description, and ultimately they didn't want to confess their sins. They were not willing. I would read exactly from Genesis 3:12-13. Says, "The woman who thou gavest to be with me, she gave me the tree, and I did eat." The woman put blame on the serpent, saying, "The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat." We can put ourselves in those names there. We can put ourselves like, We can put our friend's name who led us astray into doing sins. We can put our siblings, our mates in college, our mates at work who have made us into doing sins that we initially didn't want to do, but ultimately the circumstances were there that we did it. We can put ourselves in many of the circumstances, that examples that we had so far, to understand how we have wronged against God and we have sinned, but we still have not confessed for many of them. Do we often say, God, because of the circumstance, I have sinned. I did not have a choice. Do we say that I did not have a choice? God, it's because of my friend that I did this. It was because we are blinded. We had a choice. We actually had a choice and we are blinded that we had a choice. We think that we did not have a choice but to commit a sin. But we are wrong in thinking that we did not have a choice in certain circumstances. We always have a choice. We just have to accept it and we need to confess. The spirit of self-justification actually originated in the father of lies and has been shown through sons of Adam and the daughters of Adam through us. True repentance will lead us to bear our guilt and acknowledge it without deception or hypocrisy. It will convict us to accept and ask for forgiveness. The perfect confession, I think, can be seen like how we talked about the poor publican, was not even willing to lift up his eyes and said, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I think that confession is the best to look up to. Among the crises that we are in currently, the call to confession is of the utmost importance because God's coming is near. I do not need to stress on the signs that are going around us, the sickness, the turmoil, the hardships that people are facing, the depth, the deaths that are happening in our own families, the poverty, the lack of confidence in the system that we have, the lack of faith, the lack of hope in seeing the next day. The second coming is actually very near. Confession should be our priority to make things straight with God, because we don't know when our last day is going to be, before our time runs out. In the end, I want to just read from 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all our unrighteousness. So I hope that I have brought a little more light into how confession is important and how this time that we are in currently is a time that we have to look back into ourselves. Apart from trying to cope up with the situation that is going around, our personal battle that we have, and how we treat our fellow humans that we have trespassed, how to confess to God that we have sinned against, and to ultimately make things straight with God, because His coming is near and we don't know when we are going to be called back again. I hope we are able to confess our sins to God and to our fellow human beings in the right way and not find justification among ourselves and to give excuses and to be blinded from the sins that we have committed. Thank you.
I would like to thank Winston for that wonderful message and thank God for speaking through him on an important aspect of our life, that we need to confess our sins and throwing in more light and enabling us to understand how important it is for us to confess our sins. And we thank God for Dr. Ricky as he has shared this message with us. May God bless you and your work. Now at this time, we would be rendered by a special song by Miss Cherry Hansa. Cherry would be presenting to us a song.
You were the Word at the beginning, one with God the Word Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What
for that wonderful song. We were blessed. At this time, I would like to thank all the participants for taking part in today's Vespers meeting. I would like to thank General Babi and the entire team at Ghatshila and the children for taking up the lively song service. I would also like to thank Pastor M.G. Kisku for the opening prayer, and Jeff Henry for the Bible quiz. We thank Sonu and Ricky for that wonderful song, and Winston for that wonderful message of reminding us on how important it is for us to confess our sins, and also Cherry for that wonderful song. We have few prayer requests, and I would like to read out the prayer request. We have Mrs. Asha Lata Baske, Pastor Laban Rao and Lavlina. They are sick and they need our prayers. Mr. Soren and family, and also for Chinky and Silky. We have Mrs. Christy Pearson, who's also suffering with COVID, and she's very sick. We need to pray for her too. We also pray for Mrs. Florence and Selena as they're recovering from COVID. Also would like to pray for Mrs. Lily Ba and her family as they have lost their loved one. So we'll pray for them. We'll pray for all the hospitals and the institutions all around the world who are struggling with this pandemic, and the entire healthcare team. If any one of you have any other prayer requests, please let me know. I would like to ask Mr. George Hembron to offer prayer first, followed by Mr. Augustine Daniel as we pray. Any more prayer requests before they pray?
Rajiv, this is Melvin speaking. I have a request for prayer. I just got a message now that one of our church family, a visitor at our church, was involved in a fatal car accident. Actually was fatal for the guys in the front. I believe it was a semi-truck that overturned, and he was driving in a pickup truck, and it was dark here, so he ran into the pickup, that semi. He's admitted in the hospital now in a very serious condition. So if you can keep Danny Gonzalez in your prayer, please. Danny Gonzalez. Thank you.
Okay, we'll pray for Mr. Danny Gonzalez also, as he has met in the accident. So any other prayer requests we have, you can share. And also add in the other sick people who, there are so many people who are affected with COVID. So we'd also include all those names as well. And if any of you have any other prayer requests, please let us know. Okay, we'll go ahead then. First, George Bhaiya, you can pray, followed by Dad.
Good evening, everybody, and happy Sabbath to all. And it's time for prayer. And we are having two prayers that is very obviously meaning that we are having special prayer requests, and therefore we need to seek the Lord in prayer even more earnestly. Hence, we have all decided, as the program has been prepared, that two prayers would be done. So I would pray, and there are many prayer requests. I was just looking into the inbox, and I could see many prayer requests, and even more requests I am having in my mobile phone. So I would like to pray for everybody this evening, so that God's healing will be for each and everyone.
So George,
yes.
Why don't you pray for the 11 names, and I will continue from the rest of the names.
Sir, can you please come again? I could not get you.
We have about 23 names as a prayer request.
Exactly.
So you can go with the 12 names, and rest of the names I will cover it.
All right. The 12 names which we have in the inbox, that's what you're saying?
Yeah.
Okay. Just one. Yeah. Okay. Fine. So you have this to Agustinosa? Okay. Fine. All right. I would like to pray in Hindi. And shall we all close our eyes? आइए हम सब प्रार्थना करेंगे कि ईश्वर हमें चंगाई बख्शेंगे ताकि हम लोग ईश्वर के अद्भुत कार्य हमारे जीवन में देख पाएंगे. और सिर्फ अद्भुत कार्य ही देखना काफ़ी नहीं है, परंतु अपने जीवन में महत्वपूर्ण बदलाव जो हमें लेके आना है वो भी हमारे जीवन में ईश्वर के जो उत्तर हमारे जीवन में आते हैं प्रार्थना के, उसके द्वारा हमें बदलाव लेके आना है. आइए हम लोग अपने सर को झुकाएंगे और हम लोग प्रार्थना करेंगे. हे हमारे स्वर्ग पिता, तुझे हम धन्यवाद देते हैं सुंदर समय के लिए जो तूने हमें दिया है. धन्यवाद देते हैं कि तू महान परमेश्वर है, दयालु प्रेमी पिता है, और तू हमें कभी भी हमारे तकलीफ के समय में नहीं छोड़ता है. तू हर समय हमारे साथ रहता है और ये हमें देखा है. काफ़ी कठिन हालत से हम गुजर चुके हैं पिछले हफ्ते और उसके पहले कुछ दिनों से, जब इस कोरोना के सेकंड वेव हमारे ऊपर में आया है तो हमने देखा है कि किस अद्भुत तरीके से तूने हमारे जीवन में काम किया है, हमारे परिवार में काम किया है. हमारे प्रियजन, हमारे परिवार के सदस्य काफ़ी गंभीर रूप से बीमार हो गए थे, लेकिन हमने देखा है कि तूने चंगाई हमारे परिवार में प्रदान किया है. लेकिन फिर भी हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि हमारी इच्छा नहीं परंतु तेरी इच्छा हमेशा हमारे जीवन में बनी रहे. इस शाम को फिर से जब हम अपने आप को तेरे सामने लेके आते हैं, हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू हमारे प्रार्थनाओं को सुन, हमारे प्रार्थनाओं का तू उत्तर दे, क्योंकि तूने कहा है कि अगर तुम्हें कुछ मांगना है तो तू मुझे मांग और मैं तेरे प्रार्थनाओं को उत्तर दूंगा. और इस शाम के समय में हम और भी तुझसे प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू हमारे प्रार्थनाओं का तू उत्तर दे. हमारे बीच में बहुत सारे लोग मौजूद हैं जिनको प्रार्थना की आवश्यकता है. हम प्रार्थना करते हैं विशेष रूप से हमारे बीच में जो प्रेयर रिक्वेस्ट आया है, आशालता बास्के जो बहुत बीमार है और झारखंड में रहती है, और हम नहीं जानते किस प्रकार से और कितना गंभीरतापूर्वक वो बीमार हैं, लेकिन उनको हम अपने प्रार्थना में याद करते हैं ताकि तेरा चमत्कारी चंगाई उनके जीवन में वे देख सकें. हम फिर प्रार्थना करते हैं पास्टर लेबन के लिए, लवलीना के लिए, जिनके लिए हम रोज सुबह शाम प्रार्थना पहले से करते आए हैं, लेकिन हम आज फिर उनको अपने प्रार्थना में याद करते हैं. पास्टर लेबन जो हॉस्पिटल में है और लवलीना वो भी हॉस्पिटल में है, दोनों बीमार हैं और उनको बहुत आवश्यक है कि तू उनके जीवन में अपना आश्चर्य काम कर, क्योंकि हम विश्वास करते हैं कि तू परमेश्वर, चंगा करने वाला परमेश्वर है. और हम तुझसे इसलिए प्रार्थना करते हैं क्योंकि हम तुझ पर विश्वास करते हैं. अगर तेरे पास हम नहीं आएंगे तो हम नहीं जानते हैं कहीं और हम कहाँ जाएंगे. इसलिए हम अपने आप को तेरे सामने पूरी तरीके से रखना चाहते हैं और अपने प्रार्थना को तेरे सामने रखते हैं. पास्टर लेबन और लवलीना को तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं. हम धन्यवाद देते हैं कि पूना में आईवी फुफू को हम आज मीटिंग में देख पा रहे हैं. वो पिछले हफ्ते बहुत बीमार थी कोविड की अवस्था से, उसको अभी चंगाई प्राप्त हुई है, उसके लिए हम बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं. प्रार्थना करते हैं क्लाउडियस फुफा के लिए जो अभी भी अस्पताल में है. हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू उसे हिम्मत दे, उन्हें ताकत दे, जो भी दवाइयाँ उनके शरीर में दी जा रही है, जो ऑक्सीजन दिया जा रहा है वेंटिलेटर पे, जब वो रिकवरी प्रोसेस में है, हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू उन्हें एक क्षण भी ना छोड़, उनका हिम्मत को तू बनाए रख, उनका धाड़स को तू बनाए रख, और जो भी दवा उनको दी जाती है, जिस प्रकार से भी उनकी चंगाई का प्रक्रिया डॉक्टरों के द्वारा किया जाता है, हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तेरा हाथ इन सब प्रक्रियाओं के ऊपर में मौजूद और बने रहे ताकि वो भी तेरे चमत्कारी आशीष को ग्रहण कर सके, तेरे चमत्कारी चंगाई को ग्रहण कर सके। हम धन्यवाद देते हैं कि आईवी फूफू और क्लाउडिस फूफा का परिवार, जिसमें प्रीति, नौमी और छोटा क्लेटन और कुकू और क्विंस्टन, जेड, सब कोई बीमार हो गए थे, लेकिन धीरे धीरे करके हम देख पा रहे हैं सबको चंगाई प्राप्त हो रही है। जेड के पिताजी को भी हमने कुछ दिन पहले खोया और परमेश्वर पूरा परिवार शोकित है। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि उनको हिम्मत दे, उनको ढाढ़स दे, ताकि इस दुख भरी अवस्था में पूरा परिवार जब टूट गया है, एक प्रियजन को उन्होंने खोया है, उनको आशा मिले कि वे लोग फिर से उनको जब तू बादलों में होके हमें लेने के लिए आएगा उनको देख पाएंगे और साथ ही साथ सब मिलकर के स्वर्ग राज में प्रवेश कर पाएंगे। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं सिल्की के लिए और चिंकी के लिए, और साथ ही साथ हम तनु के लिए भी प्रार्थना करना चाहते हैं जो इस वक्त रांची में है। सिल्की और चिंकी दोनों कोविड पॉजिटिव है, लेकिन उनका रिपोर्ट हमें जब सुनने को मिला हमें अच्छा लगा सुनकर के कि उनकी तबीयत अभी ठीक है, फीवर है, खांसी है, लेकिन प्रार्थना करने की आवश्यकता हमें है कि जिस किसी अवस्था में वे क्यों ना हो वो उन अवस्था में से निकल करके चंगाई प्राप्त कर सके। इसलिए इस वक्त जब हम अपने पूरे परिवार को याद करते हैं तो साथ ही साथ चिंकी और चिल्की सिल्की को भी और तनु को भी हमारे प्रार्थना में याद करते हैं। उनका जो समय है बहुत दुख भरा समय है और पूरा परिवार दुख महसूस किया है, और अभी वे लोग जब रिकवरी प्रोसेस में है आत्मिक और शारीरिक तरीके से, उनको तू चंगाई प्रदान कर। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं फिर से हमारे बीच मिसेस क्रिस्टी पियर्सन है जो कि बहुत बीमार है और वह सालिसबरी पार्क अस्पताल में एडमिट भर्ती की गई है। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं उनको भी तू चंगाई प्रदान करें, क्योंकि बीमार अवस्था में उनको बहुत कमज़ोर महसूस हो रहा होगा और वो फिर से अच्छा होने चाहती है, और हम भी चाहते हैं कि वो फिर से अच्छी होने पाए, और हम इसलिए प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू मिसेस क्रिस्टी पियर्सन को आशीष दे, अपना चंगाई रूपी हाथ उन पर तू रख, ताकि वे तेरे चंगाई को महसूस कर सके। ना केवल शारीरिक चंगाई के लिए हम प्रार्थना करते हैं, परंतु साथ ही साथ हम सबों के लिए आत्मिक चंगाई के लिए भी प्रार्थना करते हैं। हम जितने कोई भले चंगे हैं, शारीरिक अवस्था हमारा ठीक है, हम लोग को आत्मिक चंगाई प्रदान कर, ताकि हम अपने तन मन धन से तुझको मान सके और तेरे चरणों में अपने आप को रख सके। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू हमारे परिवार को फिर से एकजुट बनाए रख। हम बहुत धन्यवाद देते हैं कि इतने कोई आज हम लोग जमा हो पाए हैं, और हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू इसी प्रकार से जीपीडी हेम्ब्रम ग्रुप को एकता में बनाए रखेगा, ताकि हर एक दुख सुख में हम एक दूसरे का साथ दे सके और हर एक अवस्था में हम एक दूसरों के लिए खड़े होने सके, और तू हमारे पूरे परिवार के ऊपर अपना छत्र छाया बनाए रखे और पूरे परिवार को अपने प्यार में और अपने शांति में बनाए रखे, और साथ साथ जिस प्रकार से हम देख रहे हैं हमारे जीवन में हमारे आसपास जो घटनाएं घट रही हैं, ये बहुत सटीक संकेत है कि तेरा आना इस पृथ्वी में फिर से दूसरी बार बहुत जल्द है, और हम अपने आप को तैयार कर सके। परमेश्वर हमारे पापों को क्षमा कर और हमारे हर एक कमजोरियों को तो दूर कर, शैतान से लड़ने के लिए हमें ताकत दे और हम अपने आप को तेरे राज के लिए तैयार कर सके, साथ ही साथ तेरा गवाही का काम भी कर सके और तेरा गवाही का काम उन लोगों के बीच में कर सके जो लोग तेरे बारे नहीं जानते हैं, और वे लोग भी तेरे बारे जान सके और वे लोग भी अपने आप को तेरे लिए तैयार कर सके। फिर से जितने लोगों के लिए हमने प्रार्थना किया उनको तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं, और एक विशेष व्यक्ति के बारे में हम को अभी अभी खबर मिली है जिनका नाम है मिस्टर डैनी गोंजालिस, जो यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स अमेरिका के रहने वाले हैं। उनका एक्सीडेंट हो गया है और वे बहुत गंभीर तरीके से एक्सीडेंट उनके शरीर में चोट आई है और वे हॉस्पिटल में एडमिटेड है। हम नहीं जानते कि उसका क्या अवस्था है, लेकिन हम इतना जानते हैं कि तूने पूरा सिचुएशन को संभाला है, और उनके ऊपर हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि अपना हाथ तू रख और उनको भी चंगाई प्रदान कर। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं कि तू उनके परिवार को, उनके आसपास जितने भी उनके रिश्तेदार हैं और उनके शुभचिंतक सबके लिए हम प्रार्थना करते हैं, ताकि इस कठिन अवस्था में उन लोगों को भी हिम्मत और धाड़स मिले, ताकि वे लोग अपना सहयोग उन को दे सके। और विशेष रूप से मिस्टर डैनिक गोंजालेस को फिर से तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं। जिस प्रकार से भी उनका ट्रीटमेंट होगा, जिस प्रकार से डॉक्टर और नर्सेस उनका ट्रीटमेंट करेंगे और ऑपरेशन की आवश्यकता होगी या दवाइयों की आवश्यकता होगी, हम नहीं जानते हैं, लेकिन सारी प्रक्रिया में तू उनके साथ रहे, उनको चंगाई प्रदान कर, उनको ये बता कि तू परमेश्वर है, तुझको छोड़ करके और कोई और परमेश्वर नहीं है। हम धन्यवाद देते हैं फिर से कि ये मौका हमको मिला कि हम इतने लोगों के लिए प्रार्थना कर सके। सबों को फिर से तेरे हाथ में सौंपते हैं, और सबों को अवस्था तू जानता है, और सबों को तू चंगाई प्रदान कर। इस छोटी सी विनती को यीशु मसीह के नाम से मांगते हैं, दया करके सुन और ग्रहण कर। आमेन।
महान स्वर्गीय पिता, तुझे धन्यवाद देते हैं इस सुंदर समय के लिए। प्रभु जी, तू महान परमेश्वर है, हमें प्रेम करता है, हमारा जरूरतों को पूरी करता है। प्रभु जी, इस वक्त तेरा पास आते हैं क्योंकि हमारा सहायता तेरे ओर से मिलती है, और एक दो तीन और अधिक जन जिस जगह में हम कटे होते हैं, तेरा उपस्थिति हम लोगों के बीच में होता है। इसलिए हम जानते हैं प्रभु जी, इस प्रार्थना सभा में हम प्रार्थना निवेदन लेकर आते हैं, ताकि हमें आशीष करते हैं, हमारा प्रार्थनाओं को उत्तर देते हैं। प्रभु जी, तो महान परमेश्वर है। हम प्रार्थना करने पहला हम अपना अपना पाप को मानते हैं प्रभु जी, हमारा पापों को क्षमा कर, ताकि हमें तेरा लहू से शुद्ध होकर हम विनती प्रार्थना कर सकते हैं। प्रभु जी, हम विशेष प्रार्थना करते हैं मिस्टर अशोक शागुर का परिवार के लिए, जो हॉस्पिटल में भर्ती किया गया है। प्रभु जी, हम नहीं जानते हैं उनका हालत, जब भर्ती किया गया उनको ऑक्सीजन नहीं मिल रहा है, तकलीफ में है। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं उन्हें आशीष दे, तेरा कृपा और अनुग्रह हो, ताकि उनको सही इलाज करते हुए वो खुशी और आनंद के साथ अपना घर लौट सकते हैं। हम विशेष प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी, लिली का परिवार के लिए। आप जानते हैं उस घर में एक बड़ा सा तकलीफ और मुसीबत खड़ी हो गया। हम जानते हैं लिली उस परिवार में कैसा संभालेगी, उन दोनों बेटा और बेटियों को कैसा अगुवाई करेगी, उनको संतवन दे। उनका जो भी समस्या है प्रभु जी, उनको दूर कर, उनको आशीष दे, ताकि अपना ज्ञान और बुद्धि से उस परिवार को अगुवाई कर सकेंगे। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं बबली का मामा, जो कोविड बीमारी से ग्रसित है, उनको भी आशीष दे। प्रभु जी, तो महान परमेश्वर है, हमें चंगाई प्रदान करता है, आशीष देते हैं, और हम बबली का मामा के लिए प्रार्थना करते हैं और आपका हाथों पर समर्पित करते हैं। प्रभु जी, जो उचित और जो आशीष उनके लिए जरूरी है, प्रभु जी हम लोग प्रार्थना करते हैं, ताकि उनको अगुवाई कर और आशीष से परिपूर्ण कर। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं जो लोटस का दादी जो जोड़ापुर में है उनका भी आशीष दे और जो तकलीफ और इस दुखी अवस्था में प्रभु जी उनको दाढ़स दे और हम बबली का नानी के लिए भी प्रार्थना करते हैं और समस्त परिवार को तो जानते हैं प्रभु जी वो लोगों का तकलीफ और मुसीबत कितना है। हम जब एक एक परिवार को हम लोग देखते हैं प्रभु जी हर परिवार में बहुत सारा समस्या के साथ वो लोग अपना जीवन बिता रहे हैं। प्रभु जी आप उन परिवार को शुद्धि ले, उनका जरूरत उनको पूरी कर, उनको आशीष दे और हम चाहते हैं प्रभु जी लोग सब मिलकर तेरे लिए गवाही दे सकते हैं क्योंकि तू हमारा परमेश्वर जो हमें देखरेख करते हैं, हमारा समस्या को दूर करते हैं। इस तरह हम सब तेरा उपस्थिति में आकर हम लोग गवाही दे सकते हैं। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं बबलू जो मानसिक तनाव से अपना जीवन बिता रहे हैं प्रभु जी इस तनाव को आप दूर कर सकते हैं, उनका मानसिक तनाव को तू आशीष दे, उस बीमारी से उसको दूर कर और जैसा वो लोग विश्वास करेंगे और तेरे ओर निर्भर करेंगे प्रभु जी इस मानसिक समस्या दूर हो सकती है। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं अंस्ता फैमिली जो सरेकेला में है वो लोग एक परिवार का सदस्य को खो दिया और आपका संतावन आपका आशीष उस परिवार में जरूरी है प्रभु जी आप उनको संतावन दे। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं मिसेस कपरा हंसदक और उसका बेटी जो कोविड से वो लोग मुक्त हो रहे हैं और हम चाहते हैं प्रभु जी संपूर्ण ताकत और बल दे ताकि वो लोग खुशी और आनंद के साथ आपकी सेवा कर सकते हैं और कपरा का बेटी और लॉली के लिए भी प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी उस परिवार में आनंद और खुशी हो ताकि वो लोग सब तेरे लिए गवाही दे सकते हैं। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं जो परिवार में तकलीफ है जो रिटायरी लोग हैं जो हॉस्पिटल में डॉक्टर्स नर्सेस और विभिन्न प्रकार का काम करते हैं जो इस कोविड बीमारी के साथ लड़ते हुए अपना जान को बहुत खतरे में डालकर वो लोग काम कर रहे हैं प्रभु जी हर एक कर्मचारी को याद करते हैं उन्हें आशीष दे उस बीमारी से वो लोग दूर रख ताकत और बल प्रदान कर ताकि सही सलामत वो लोग सेवा कर सकते हैं। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं हमें आत्मिक रीति से हमें आशीष चाहिए और जैसा हम लोग शारीरिक चंगाई के लिए प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी उसी रीति हम आत्मिक अभिवृद्धि के लिए हम प्रार्थना करते हैं हमें अगुवाई कर हमें मदद कर ताकि हम लोग पवित्र शास्त्र पढ़कर हम तेरा सच्चाई को ग्रहण करते हुए हम लोग एक अच्छा इंसान बन सकते हैं। हम प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी मिस्टर कैलाश वो कैंसर से अपना जीवन बिता रहे हैं प्रभु जी उनको ताकत और बल दे जो दवाई और आहार लेते हैं उस पर तेरा आशीष हो ताकि वो इस बीमारी से मुक्त होकर एक अच्छा जीवन बिता सकते तेरा इच्छा हो प्रभु जी उनको तेरा हाथों पर समर्पित करते हैं। इसी तरह हम प्रार्थना करते हैं मिस्टर Deepu Topno aur Mr. Kapil dono covid bimari se apna bistar mein hai prabhu ji aur hum unko tera haathon par samarpit karte hain unhe aashish de agwai kar hum prarthna karte hain is covid bimari parivar ko alag karte hain aur hamara shanti aur परिवार का एकता को तोड़ते हैं प्रभु जी ये शैतान का बहुत बड़ा काम परिवार को तोड़ने में और अलग करने में कामयाब हो गया फिर हम प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी हम आपको चाहते हैं आप हमारा पिता है हमारा तकलीफ और मुसीबत को समाधान करने वाला परमेश्वर है हम प्रार्थना करते हैं प्रभु जी जितना प्रार्थना निवेदन आपके चरणों पर हम रखे हैं तो आशीष दे अगुवाई कर और हमें सही उत्तर दे ताकि प्रभु जी हम तेरे लिए एक नया जीवन एक अच्छा जीवन एक गवाही का जीवन बिता सकते हैं हमारा पाप अपराधों को क्षमा कर इस जी पी डी हेमराम में जो कोई जुड़ा है हर एक सदस्य को हम प्रार्थना करते हैं और प्रभु जी इस विश्राम दिन में तेरे लिए एक अच्छा इंसान बन सकते हैं इस प्रार्थना मसीह के नाम से मांगते हैं सुनर ग्रहण कर आमेन
When you take a look around, it ain't hard to find. Everybody's got things that money can't buy. If the ones you love are sitting right beside you, they're not safe.